Okay, I'm going to talk a little bit about these Japanese saws and do a short demonstration for you on how to use them and how and what I believe is the philosophy of using them as far as efficient cutting. I have these are the three that I use all the time. All of these are by the same manufacturer, Gayu Chuko, the Swan, and it's the only brand I've ever owned and the only brand I'll probably ever use. They're very reasonably priced. You can get them at Japan Woodworker. All three of these are, the handles are basically will last you forever, and you just replace the blades when you need a replacement. They're very easy to replace the blades. So let me talk about the three different ones that I'll show you. This is the finest one that I have. It's a 0.3 millimeter. It has the stiffener on the back. It's strictly for fine cross cutting. This is also a cross cut saw. This is a 0.5 millimeter. It's a little thicker and doesn't have the stiffener, so it will pass all the way through material. It's one of my favorite ones. And then this is just for when you need to get medieval on stuff and you need to make an aggressive cross cut of a 2x4 to drop something or cut a board of hardwood at a rough length without having to get your skill saw out or jigsaw to make a rough cut. It'll just get right to it. This is the rip portion, and this is very, very aggressive, but not many saws will cut straight into end grain as efficiently as this does. So I'm going to show you how to use, I'm going to primarily be using these two to, I'm going to cut a tenon in the end of this piece of sepo. So I've got this marked out. I marked it out with my combination square. And I'm going to attempt to leave all the lines and just leave just this material here in the middle so we have a tenon. So say, for example, you were doing a big door job or something and you forgot one tenon on the end of a board. So instead of going back through and resetting up your entire table saw, however you're cutting your tenons, in just a few moments, a few minutes, you can cut a very accurate tenon and have this back into your workflow with just a couple hand tools and a chisel. So I'm going to cut this in this setup here on my homemade multifunction table. This is my multifunction table that has the perforated holes in it like Festool's does. And I've had this piece of mahogany that has this rabbit cut out of it. I've had this for years, and this is just the handiest thing for making all kinds of, it's just a great tool. So the first thing I'm going to do is talk a little bit about my philosophy of using these tools. Whenever I see a Western person use these Japanese saws, I always see them approach the work. Even though it's a pull saw and cuts on the pull, I always see them approach the work with the handle up. So you're using it in the same manner that you would use a push Western style saw. These saws will cut like that because they're so aggressive, they'll cut just about any way you do it. But the way they really work is that if you drop that handle and let the handle be down, and so you're actually now pulling your workpiece into your stop material or your work table that you're cutting on, and you're letting gravity and the force of gravity pull the blade down at the same time, straightening and tensioning the blade at the same time, instead of the lifting action, which is also more taxing and wearing on you to hold your arm up to cut, versus that if you just have your hand down like this. But I think if that's the way you're raised, and it took me a while to figure it out. You know, I've been cutting with these for 25 years. This handle is actually 25 years old. This was one of the first nice woodworking tools that I bought for myself. And I don't know how many replacement blades I've gone through, but I still have the same handle. But it took me a while to figure it out too. I use these a lot, and one of these blades usually lasts me about 2.5 to 3 years before it just doesn't want to cut anymore. And at that point, I never throw them away. I take them and I grind the teeth off of them and I use them as scraper blades because the steel is so excellent. It's good and flexible for turning into a scraper blade. So yeah, it's a fantastic value. I mean, the blade, the replacement blades aren't very expensive, and the way they last and the amount of material that you'll cut with them, you can't afford not to use them.